गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. सो अप टू नाउ आई हैव एक्सप्लेन यू द फंडामेंटल कॉन्सेप्ट्स इन द केमिस्ट्री. आई हैव ऑलमोस्ट एक्सप्लेन्ड ऑल द थिंग्स विच आर टोल्ड यू इन द वेरी फर्स्ट क्लास, द बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट्स विच यू कम अक्रॉस इन बोथ फर्स्ट ईयर एंड सेकेंड ईयर इंटरमीडिएट. All the basic concepts are explained to you, not in detail, but briefly I have explained you the all the concepts. So while doing the lessons in first year and second year chemistry, the basic things which I have explained you may come across, then we can you can understand the topics. So from today we shall start our first year chemistry syllabus. Now in the today's class I will explain you what are the important lessons we come across in first year chemistry, and also the topics which they involve, and what are the important lessons for objective and also for IP examination. All that things will be explained in this class. So here the first year chemistry first lesson to us is is well known to you, which you have discussed in your 9th class and also in 10th class. The same topics will be repeated here: Rutherford's model, Bohr's model, quantum numbers, shapes of orbitals, and how to write the electronic configuration, and Planck's quantum theory, photoelectric effect. All the things will be studied in this lesson, which is very familiar to you. And all the topics which you have studied in your lower class will be studied here: isotopes, atomic number, atomic weight, isotones, isobars. All the things will be discussed here. Fundamental particles of an atom, all the talk. And again, second one. Periodic classification of elements. Periodic classification of elements. Here, how the periodic table is constructed, into how many blocks it is divided. First, who discovered the periodic table? What are roots? What are periods? And so all such things will be discussed in total about periodic table. In this lesson will be discussed very clearly. And again, third one is chemical bonding. In this lesson we will discuss in detail about types of bonds: ionic bond, covalent bond, coordinate covalent bond, hydrogen bond and sigma bond, pi bond, how they overlap, and about hybridization. And here the new topic in this lesson is molecular orbital theory. How can we write the MOED diagrams? That is very new topic to you. And remaining all other topics are studied in your lower classes. So in this lesson we will study about different types of bonds. And after that, states of matter. States of matter. In this, we will study about how matter is classified. Matter is classified into solids, liquids, gases. Here in this lesson, we will study about gases and liquids. about solids we will study in second year. So here different types of gas laws, Boyle's law, Charles' law, Avogadro's law, and all the things, and again Maxwell's gas laws, ideal gas, what is meant by ideal gas, all these things are studied in this lesson. And also about liquid state, vapor pressure, what is laminar flow, what is the vapor pressure of a liquid, what is Boyle temperature, what is critical temperature, all that will be discussed in this lesson. And again stoichiometry, so this is very new topic to you, but the concepts involved in this lesson are discussed in your lower classes. How to balance a chemical equation, how to calculate the molecular weight, all the things will be discussed in detail in this lesson. The name of this lesson is very new to you, but the topics involved in this lesson are well known to you in the lower classes. So this is stoichiometry. After stoichiometry, thermodynamics. So in this lesson we will discuss about laws of thermodynamics and state functions and state variables. First law of thermodynamics, second law of thermodynamics, third law of thermodynamics, all the things will be discussed. And what is chemical reaction, what is endothermic reaction, what is exothermic reaction, all these are discussed here. And again chemical equilibrium and acids and bases, this is complete lesson. Chemical equilibrium, acids and bases. So in the chemical equilibrium we will discuss about what is a chemical reaction, when the reaction will be in equilibrium state. In order to be a chemical reaction in equilibrium state, which conditions should be followed, all the things will be discussed. And in the case of acids and bases, already I have told you the brief introduction: Arrhenius theory, Bronsted theory, Lewis theory, conjugate acid, conjugate base, salt hydrolysis, ionic product of water, all the things will be discussed in this acids and bases. After that, hydrogen and its compounds. Hydrogen and its compounds. So where the hydrogen is placed in the periodic table, and why it is placed only there, and what are the compounds formed by hydrogen, and how they are prepared, and their properties, all the things are discussed in this lesson. Hydrogen and its compounds. After that, S law of elements. So here the S block elements are two types, 1A group elements and 2A group elements. All these are explained here. And what are the compounds found by them, what are the physical properties, and what are the chemical properties, all the things are explained in this lesson. S block elements. So after S block elements, P block elements. So here generally the P block elements contain 6 groups, 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th, 7th, 0. But in first year we will study about only 3rd group and 4th group only, whereas 5th group, 6th group, 7th group and 0 group will be studied in second year. So in the first year we will study about only 3rd group and 4th group, that is boron family and carbon family. So these two will be discussed in first year only, not all P block elements. Whereas in the S block we have two groups, they are 1A and 2A, both are discussed here only. But in the case of P block only two groups are discussed here.
After that, environmental chemistry.
Next lesson here is environmental chemistry. So in the environmental chemistry, what are the layers present in atmosphere? What are the different types of gases? How acid rains are formed? How global warming is formed? What are the precautions to take? And how holes are formed in ozone layer? How water becomes pollution? All the things are discussed in environmental chemistry.
After that, the final lesson is organic chemistry. So in the case of organic chemistry, first we discuss about fundamentals. First fundamentals are discussed. After that, purification. Purification methods. And after that, about hydrocarbons. All these things will be discussed. And also about finally benzene. We can here we shall explain about benzene also. All this will be discussed in the case of organic chemistry. So in the case of fundamentals, we will discuss how reaction occur and how can we name the organic compound, nomenclature, different techniques, different types of fissions, different types of reactions, different types of reagents. All will be discussed here in fundamentals. And here in the purification, how metals are purified by crystallization, fractional distillation, or by chromatographic method, all that will be discussed in the purification methods. In the case of hydrocarbons, alkanes are discussed, and benzene, and also about the carcinogenic agents also we can discuss. All this is all about the first year chemistry. Here, the important thing is up to lower classes, up to 10th class, you will study the physics and chemistry in combined form as physical chemistry. But here in first year intermediate, the physics and chemistry will be studied differently. So, physics is one separate subject, chemistry is one separate subject. So, you should concentrate perfectly on both the subjects separately. So in the lower class, in the 10th class, if you keep chemistry as a choice and you will read the physics perfectly like that, you may do. But here you cannot do it like that. You should read completely, then only you can score the marks, and you can score the marks in objective as well as IP. So all these are the lessons involved in first year chemistry. Thank you.